We really do live in a strange world. It's crazy that there are people in power who feel that they can get away with doing almost anything they can dream up, such as build an entire city with no one in it, making its real estate virtually unaffordable. I want to show you something amazing and insane at the same time. Yes, I'm talking about China and their ghost cities. Like all other nations, China wanted economic growth. So to increase their GDP, they decided to allow capitalistic developers to come in and offer real estate, expensive real estate, to those who could afford it. Now at that time, the investors did see their investments double, even triple, all due to the speed of the development. The construction of this real estate was so rapid that it outpaced the people's ability to move into this property. And for every other piece of property built next to it, made the property value and cost of living go up. If you wanted a skyscraper, it would be built in less than a month. I'm talking about a little over 2 weeks. No joke. This is how fast these buildings go up. These people are like real life Lego men. So the next thing you know, you've got an entire city with miles of vacant homes, offices, businesses, hospitals, shopping malls. And so now the property costs too much to live in, so nobody lives there. And who would? Even if you're rich, who'd want to move into an empty city? How could you live there? There are no open stores, there's no neighbors. You would have to have everything delivered or leave the city just to buy groceries. That would suck. Unless, of course, you're trying to live out some sick fantasy of being the last person on Earth. So, these ghost cities that they build remain empty for years. And when I say cities, I mean that there are over 50 of them in China. Ordo City, located in Ordos, Inner Mongolia, is a 34,000 square mile city labeled the ghost city of China. Only about 2% of the city has been occupied, a city that was built to hold over a million. Much of the property was abandoned and left incomplete by developers. What's strange about this city today is that it's divided into inhabited and uninhabited regions. So even though there are people there, it still looks like a ghost town. Thamestown, located in the Songjiang district, occupying an area of over 1 square kilometer, was designed for a population of 10,000 and is now just a tourist attraction or a popular scene for weddings. It was named after the Thames River in London, and the entire city is modeled after the old classic Victorian British town style. In the Conch Bay district of Tianjin, we have an unfinished replica of Manhattan and remains incomplete to this day and empty. It seemed like a cool idea at the time of construction, but no investor today will even touch it. In Dongguan, China, we have the New South China Mall, the largest mall in the world, next to the Dubai Mall, and is the emptiest mall in the world. This mall is almost 10 million square feet, but only has about 40 to 50 of the 2,350 available spaces occupied. There are ghost towns like this at the edge of almost every major city in China, and these cities are causing an enormous economic bubble that will pop. There is no remedying this, folks. Some believe that these cities are being set aside for the rich and powerful elite to move into after everything else has been destroyed. These aren't cities built deep in the Himalayas or tucked secretly away from major cities in some geographically sound location. they are sitting right next to the major cities. And when the major cities go, I'm pretty sure the ghost cities will too. But these Lego men keep on building and building, and their government doesn't care about hurting the environment in the process. They don't care about pollution. They surely don't care about making people broke. They got these fresh, futuristic cities with no one in them, while the majority of their population can't afford to live in the cities that they are already in. I guess Lego men must build at all costs. I mean, they can't even wait for people to move out of their homes. They will literally build their shit around you, whether you want to move or not. Truth is stranger than fiction. You can't make this stuff up. It's insane. This is a disaster waiting to happen, folks. And the punch from this will be felt globally. In fact, it's already happening. China's economy is slowing down. Projects are being left unfinished. Their national debt is just out of control. I don't know what China has planned for these vacant cities, but unless they plan on moving people in for pennies, they'll probably become the new old ruins of China.